ninachotaka ni wewe, ni wewe tu. Ninachotaka ni wewe, ni wewe tu. Haja ya moyo wangu.
Rigo. So David escaped and went to Ramah to see Samuel. And he told him all that Saul had done to him. Then Samuel took David with him to live at Naiothi. When the report reached Saul that David was at Naioth in Ramah, verse 20, the Bible says, he sent troops to capture him. But when they arrived and saw Samuel leading a group of prophets who were prophesying, the Spirit of God came upon Saul's men, and they also began to prophesy. Verse 21, when Saul heard what had happened, he sent other troops, but the two prophesied. The same thing happened to the third one. I don't know whether you're noticing something here, that it's not just one man who was prophesying, the priest, but all that went there, they prophesied. Verse 22, finally, Saul himself went to Ramah and arrived in the great well of Seku, where are Samuel and David? He demanded. They are at Naioth in Ramah. Someone told him. But on the way to Naioth in Ramah, the Spirit of God came even upon Saul, and he too began to prophesy all the way to Naioth. He tore off his cloth and lay naked on the ground all day and all night, prophesying in the presence of Samuel. The people who were watching exclaimed, "What is this? Even Saul, a prophet." First, the book of Psalms, Psalms chapter 16. Psalms chapter 16. Are you there? Psalms chapter 16, verse 11. Psalms 16, verse 11. The Bible says in the King James Version, "Thou wilt show me the path of life. In thy presence is fullness of joy. At thy right hand there are pleasure forevermore." Father, we thank you for your word. We receive it with thanksgiving. We pray that, Lord, you are ministering to us life today. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Now, I want to continue our series about celebration. This is the second week where we're having our celebration Sunday. And today, I want to talk about the presence of God for a very short time, and then we are done. I want to talk about the presence of God. Amen. Now, in the Garden of Eden, after God had created everything, he created Adam and Eve, and he positioned them there. The Bible says these guys were enjoying life. They were having everything that they needed at their disposal. They lacked nothing. They needed nothing. They were happy. But after they sinned in the Garden of Eden, they were chased out of the presence of the Lord. And the Bible says that the angels were positioned to guard the Garden of Eden. And Adam and Eve were forced to go outside the garden to learn how to survive. I want you to know a few things here. Number one, in the Garden of Eden, the spiritual man in Adam and Eve was more active than the physical man. Remember what I told you the other day, that Adam and Eve had two pair of eyes. They had the physical eyes and they had the spiritual eyes. In the Garden of Eden, the spiritual eyes were more active and the physical eyes were not active. And immediately they sinned by eating from the forbidden tree. The Bible said that the Satan convinced Eve and told Eve, "When you eat of the tree of knowledge and knowledge of good and evil, you shall not die, but your eyes shall be open. What does it mean? Does it mean that they were not seeing? Listen to me, child of God. In the Garden of Eden, the spiritual eyes were seeing, but the physical eyes were not active. And that is why they were seeing things the way God was seeing things. The spiritual eyes were active. They could see just as God was seeing. That's why God told Adam and Eve to name all the creatures that he had created. And the Bible said that Adam named them. And God saw the name that Adam was giving to everything that God created. And he said, it is so. Listen to me, child of God. Each one of us today, you need to realize God has created you with the two pair of eyes, the spiritual eye and the physical eyes. And you know that spiritual eyes, normally, they concentrate on what God is seeing, on the superior things, but the physical eyes, which are more carnal, they are only concentrating on what the world and the nature is seeing. That's why immediately Adam sinned, his eyes were open. And what happened? Immediately their eyes were open, they realized they were naked. These guys were naked all the way from the time past, but they were concentrating on the spiritual part of it, that they were not able to see the negative. People that their spiritual eyes have been closed, they concentrate on seeing the negativity in other people without necessarily appreciating what God is doing in the lives of the people. But people that their spiritual eyes are open, they see what God is seeing. When the enemy says you are defeated, with the physical eyes, yes, you may see you are defeated. But with the spiritual eye, you are able to see exactly what God is seeing. The Bible says that the things that have been revealed, the things that we can see are temporal, but the things that are not revealed are supernatural. I'm here to declare to every child of God that as your eyes are being opened today to behold the beauty of the Lord, you shall see what the Lord is seeing. And as you see them and declare them, you are going to encounter them and to embrace them. Praise the Lord. The Bible says, there was a man by the name David. David had just been ordained to be the king of Israel. And certain victories had been given to the children of Israel through this one man called David. And the Bible said that there came a time when the enemy, when Saul, felt jealousy about him and started looking for means to destroy him. Listen to me. It is what you carry that determines the type of enemy that comes on your way. No enemy attacks any man carrying nothing. No enemy attacks any man without anything. Immediately, David conquered the Goliath and the giant, and people started celebrating, cheering him up. That's when the war began. The war you are going through today, it is because of exactly what the Lord has exposed the people to see in you. Therefore, I'm here to charge you. You are not stopping. You are not giving up of what you have been doing. You are continuing, because even though your beginning may look weaker and smaller, continue pushing on. There's brighter light ahead of you in the mighty name of Jesus. And the Bible says David became an enemy of Saul, and Saul started looking for means to destroy David. But one day, when Saul had planned to kill David, David ran to his spiritual father by the name Samuel. And immediately he arrived, he told Samuel that all that was happening. Samuel asked him, "What is happening?" He said, "Hey, Saul wants to destroy me." There's only one thing that Samuel did to David. Listen to me. I came here to challenge every child of God today. We just follow anyone. Paul says that follow me as I follow Christ. We see David now following Saul because following Samuel because Samuel was following God. They ran to a place called Naioth in Ramah. According to the Hebrew, Naioth means a dwelling place, a place of safety, a place where your pain can be healed, a place where your forgottenness can be remembered again, a place where you sit and rest and the Lord fights for you. I'm here to declare to every child of God listening to me, time for you to fight is over. It's time for you to sit and relax and wait for the Lord to fight for you. For the battle is not yours. The battle belongs to the Lord, but the victory, it is yours. When they arrived, to cut the long story short, when they arrived, the Bible says they started praising the Lord, prophesying and declaring the goodness of the Lord. I want you to get one thing here. The Bible says in the book of Luke chapter 16, verse 16, that the prophets and the law were until John. Since then, the kingdom of God is preached. Whenever the kingdom of God is preached and people receive Jesus Christ as their personal savior, I'm here to declare to you that every born again child of God, you are a prophet and you are a prophetess. You not only need to wait for someone to come from somewhere to come and prophesy over your life. Some of the so-called prophets, they prophesy. Some of them, they speak what they know about you. Some of them, they read your stars. But I'm here to declare to you, child of God, when no one is prophesying over your life, you are a child of God. You can stand and declare and go for the scripture that talks about your life and start declaring over your life and prophesying over your life. The Bible says that Adam and Eve were just out of the Garden of Eden. Since then, mankind realized in the presence of the Lord there's fullness of joy. Why do we have fullness of joy in the presence of the Lord? In the presence of the Lord, answers are given to every question in the heart of every humanity. In the presence of the Lord, one man by the name Peter, who was a coward before then, after he received the power of the Holy Spirit, in the presence of the Lord, he preached a sermon in less than 10 minutes, and 3,000 people got born again. Because he was in the presence of the Lord. Listen to me, child of God. All that you are looking for are available in the presence of the Lord. All that you have been searching for are available in the presence of the Lord. All that you have been praying for are available in the presence of the Lord. As you access the presence today, you are accessing your answers in the name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. From that moment, mankind started trying to look for the presence of God, because they were used to enjoying the goodness of the Lord. In the presence of the Lord, there is safety, there is peace, there is joy, there is love, there is provision, there is healing, there is every supply of all that you need. But since human being, he was used to rest under the grace of God in the Garden of Eden. Everything was being given to him. He was waking up in the morning, the fruits are there. He could eat of anything he wanted. No one was laboring. No one was sweating for him to encounter or to enjoy anything. He was in paradise, a place where you can eat, a place you can drink, a place you can sleep. But this was all missing. They started looking for what we call the presence of God. How are they doing that? How are they doing that? They started inventing means of accessing the presence of God. That is the beginning of religion. That is the beginning of denomination. That was the beginning of functions or some activities that people think by doing these activities they are able to bring about the presence of the Lord. They are forgotten. Listen to me, child of God. Anybody born again, the Lord is in you. The Holy Spirit is in you. And he said, I will not leave you. I will not forsake you. The power of God, the power of the Holy Spirit is dwelling in you, within you. Remember, I taught you last time that the Holy Spirit is in you, he is upon you, and he is with you. Let me repeat that again. The Holy Spirit is upon you, he is in you, and he is with you. He is upon you to empower you to serve. He is in you to lead you, and he is with you to fellowship with you. In the Old Testament, God could leave you, the Holy Spirit could leave you and come back at certain times. But in the New Testament, I have got good news for you. He is there with you. When you enter your toilet, he is right there with you. When you go to fetch water, he is right there with you. Why? He shall not leave you nor forsake you. We are living in the end times whereby only the presence of the Lord will sustain you and keep you in all the calamities of life. Samuel and David, they went to Naioth in the dwelling place of the prophets, and they decided to do what people could not imagine could deliver them. Today, as you enter into the presence of the Lord, I came to challenge you. You shall prophesy. I say you shall prophesy.
Yes.
And as you prophesy, things will start aligning themselves for you on your behalf. Genesis chapter 1. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. And the earth was empty and formless and void. And darkness was over the deep, over the face of the earth. And the Spirit of the Lord was hovering over the deep waters. And God said, let there be. And it became. In your confusion, in life that has no meaning today, as you shall stand up to prophesy, things will start aligning themselves on your behalf. Now, immediately Samuel arrived at Nayoth with David. They started prophesying. Something happened. Saul inquired of where David was because he wanted to go and kill David. And the Bible says he was informed that Samuel and David are at Nayoth. They are in the presence of the Lord. That's where they are prophesying. Saul said, I'll go. I'll send my people to go to where he is so that I can arrest him, I can kill him. But listen to me. They sent the first troop to where Samuel and David was. Immediately the enemies arrived. Instead of arresting David and Samuel, the Bible says that the Spirit of the Lord rested upon them and they started prophesying. In the presence of the Lord, no enemy will bring you down. Instead, they will team up with you and praise the same God you have been praising without fighting them, because the battle belongs to the Lord. The Bible says King Saul sent the second troop again. When the second troop went to where Samuel and David was, the Bible says the same thing happened. The Holy Spirit landed upon them and they also started to prophesy. They prophesied. They sent the third troop. They also prophesied. And the Bible says when King Saul realized that these guys are not coming back, I'm here to declare to somebody, your enemy are going to wait for the other troop to come back, but they'll not see them, because whoever is trying to bring you down, he will team up with you. He will declare and say, hey, this is a blessed child of God. I cannot curse what God has already blessed. No one can say no when God has already said yes. It doesn't matter how many people will team up to come and bring you down. I'm here to declare to you, child of God, we serve a living God. We serve a mighty one in battle. The great I am, the Yahweh, he knows every battle. He knows how to fight them. The Bible says when Saul arrived, instead of capturing David and Saul, the Holy Spirit landed upon him and he removed his clothes. He remained naked. He started prophesying while naked for 3 days. Saul was prophesying. Instead of arresting them, he was prophesying. I'm here to declare to every child of God that the Holy Spirit is already in the house. As you enter into the presence, it doesn't matter how many people are not backing up with you. Whoever is trying to attack you, I know some are going through some challenges. Maybe your enemies are financial. Maybe your enemies are in your place of work. Your enemies are in business. I'm here to declare to you, as you land in the presence of the Lord, you need to prophesy. You don't need to curse your enemy. Don't kill your enemy. We need our enemies to stay, because they must testify of what the Lord is doing in our lives. For the Bible says, the Lord shall prepare a table for us before our enemies. I don't need any of my enemy to die, because listen to me, the same enemy tarnishing your name will become the same enemy telling people about the goodness of the Lord upon your life. I see this young man by the name Joseph, the same brothers who sold him, and they said that this man is a dreamer. Let us sell him to another foreign land so that nothing good can come out of him. The same brothers to Joseph, I see them going to their father back at home, taking the good news, telling the people, hey, our brother that we sold, he is still alive. I'm here to declare to somebody, you are not alone. Greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world, because Jehovah is on your side. Those who are against you, a time is coming, they shall look at your life, they shall
shall see the God you serve. I came to announce a child of God. There is somebody by the name Daniel. He was thrown into the lion's den. The same king who commanded this guy to be thrown into the lion's den came out in the morning and he said, "Is the God, has the God delivered you? I'm here to announce your enemy are about to ask. Your enemies are about to ask. They are about to ask. They are about to ask what has happened. You will tell them, I was in the presence of the Lord, not fighting the enemy, but prophesying, declaring the goodness of the Lord, talking about the mighty work of Christ, looking at the mountains and declaring that great is mighty God. You look at the creation, you praise the Lord. You look at your children, you praise the Lord. You look at what you have not achieved, you still praise the Lord. You look at the attack, you praise the Lord. Listen to me, child of God. Only a mature believer will worship the Lord in the midst of the calamity. 2 Chronicles chapter 20, the Bible says, three troops were attacking the Israelites. These were the Amorites, the Jebusites, and the Sidesites. Now, anytime you hear about the Sidesites in the Bible, whenever you're reading your Bible, these are breed, a product of Lot and his daughters. You remember the story, Lot drank, the children gave him alcohol, he drank, then he gave birth to his own daughters. Now, those children born from Lot's daughter with Lot, these are the Amorites, the Jebusites, and the Hittites. Now, the Bible says, these three guys, they came to fight the Israelites. And the Israelites prayed. And the Lord spoke to them through Prophet Jehoshaphat. And he told them, you enter into the valley of GMI. Did you hear what I say? They were told, enter into GMI today and don't do something, don't do anything. I'll instruct you on what to do. When they arrived, the Lord told them, lift up your hands, start praising the Lord. As they were praising the Lord, the enemy saw their friends. They thought, those are our enemies. They started fighting and killing one another. Before they realized, the other troop was already out. They faced the other one. They killed themselves and they finished them all. But the Israelites were praising the Lord, jumping and shouting and celebrating of the goodness of the Lord without fighting. Listen to me, child of God. A time has come. You no longer need to fight the battle that the Lord is supposed to fight for you. You try to fight your enemy, you lose. You praise the Lord, the Lord will shame them. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. In the presence of the Lord, what do you do? Number one, once you arrive in the presence of the Lord, number one, you rest. Amen. You do what? When you work, God will rest. But when you rest, God will work. Now listen to me. The cross of Jesus Christ is a defining factor between resting and working. Before the cross of Jesus, everything was all about man's effort. That's what the Bible says, if you do this, I'll do this. If you do this, I'll do this. If you do this, I'll do this. In other words, before the cross, everything that was happening, men were doing it so that they can get God's approval or they can receive from the Lord. Are you getting me? Even forgiveness, Jesus said to the disciple and the people who are listening to him, forgive people their sins so that your heavenly Father can also do what? Forgive you. Because Jesus was preaching from the Old Testament. I hope I'm not confusing anyone here. Jesus preached from the Old Covenant, from the Old Testament. The New Testament began after Jesus died and resurrected. The New Testament begins by the death, the burial, and the resurrection of Jesus Christ. Therefore, before Jesus died, he was also preaching in the Old Testament, from the Old Testament. And this is what he said, forgive people their sins so that your heavenly Father can also forgive you. But under the dispensation after the cross, This is what Paul is saying. Just as you are forgiven, you too forgive. You are no longer forgiving to be forgiven, but you are forgiving because you have already been forgiven. In other words, it's what you receive, the product of what you receive, you are able to give out to other people. Love, not because you want to be loved back. Love because that is the nature you have in you. There's no day a chicken will produce milk and a cow will produce eggs. A chicken is a chicken. A cow is a cow. When you are born of the Spirit and of the Word of God, you are a child of God. Naturally, without being forced by anybody, you live like a new believer. You behave like a new believer. You talk like a child of God. You walk like a child of the new covenant. In grace, under the new covenant, once you arrive in the presence, you need to rest. Tell your neighbor, rest. Mwambie, rest. Someone came to me and was asking me, Pastor, do you have, I have some money here I wanted to buy. Do you have some oil I can buy so that it can help me when I go home? I told her, oil for what? Say, so that I can use it for, I said, listen, rest. You don't need oil. Then she said, the lady told me, Pastor, then teach me how to pray whenever I wake up at 3. I said, at 3, go and sleep. You know, religion has created things in the lives of people until you think this is how they're supposed to be. The Bible says the Lord gives sleep to them that he loves, and they sleep. But Pastor, unajua waislamu anamkanga saa 11, before waislamu amuke, mimi nataka niamuke, nianze kupigana na wao. You are not a witch throwing when they throw. You are a child of God. You worship the Lord, you praise him, you forget about what you're going through, and you rest in Christ. Amen. Hallelujah. I told you last month, I think it was last month or 2 months ago, when people came to me asking me that, Pastor, which weapon is the best for killing the devil? Because tumeambiwa this Sunday we are going to kill Satan. So I want to know which material is good, because alikuwa amebeba fimba akasema, is pipe enough okay? I'm a pipe in plastic. I told them none of them is okay. You don't fight the devil using tools. Another better way of fighting the devil is praying in tongues. Did you hear what I said? Listen, child of God. When you will enter the presence of the Lord, rest. Do what? Do what? When you rest, he will work. When you work, he will rest. Number two, believe. Have faith that he who began good work in your life will finish it. Can you appreciate the Lord for the guests that are coming in? That is Emma Omonge. She's in the house now. Amen. Amen. You have a seat there. Amen. People were asking me, Pastor, are you sure they are coming? Now they are here now. Amen. Can we give Jesus a better praise in the house? Hallelujah. Amen. So whenever you are in the presence, believe that he that began good work in you shall bring it to pass. Faith means resting in the finished work of Christ, assured that he that began shall surely bring everything to fulfillment. Faith doesn't require you to walk with it along with it. Faith wants you to climb on the back, keep quiet, and let it take you where it's supposed to take you. As you believe, wait to see. Number three, as you enter the presence of God, prophesy. You can only prophesy while in the presence. Prophecy is not only limited to one man in a church. Amen. And the rest are shouting, go deeper, go deeper. That's not prophecy. That is gymnastics in the church. That can I prophesy? If God has spoken to you, why are you asking me again? Can I prophesy? Hii ni michezo kanisani. Every child of God born again, filled with the Holy Spirit, you have the ability to stand and prophesy. Now you think, okay, Luke chapter 16, verse 16. Go to Luke chapter 16, verse 16. The book of Luke, 16 verse 16. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. The book of Luke, chapter 16, verse 16. Are you there? Uh-huh. I want you to read from your Bible, from your own version, not my version. Now, for those who have gone to school, you will help me understand what this means. Until John the Baptist, this is the New Living Version. The Bible says, until John the Baptist, the law of Moses and the prophets and the message of the prophets were to guide. But now the good news of the kingdom of God is preached and everyone is eager to get in. Let me read from the King James Version. The law and the prophets were until John. Since that time, the kingdom of God is preached and every man presseth into it by himself. Every child of God is a prophet and a prophetess. You don't need to run to anyone. You can stand and declare things. The Bible says, you shall decree a thing, it shall be established. Amen. Amen. So you don't need anyone to go deeper for you to receive a miracle. You are already blessed. So under the new dispensation, in the presence of the Lord, you need to stand up and declare things. This morning I was talking on the radio concerning angels, especially Ecclesiastes chapter 5 verse 6. What does the Bible say? That the angels of the Lord are standing next to you. That every time whatever you say, they are running to fulfill. As you prophesy positivity over your life, they are going there to fulfill. From today, start speaking positive over your lives. Amen. Can I hear a louder amen? Amen. Speak what you are seeing in the spirit and not what people are telling you. Speak positive, it shall be so. Number four, when you are in the presence, eat. When Adam was in the Garden of Eden, his work was to eat and to enjoy the goodness of the Lord. In the presence, read your Bible, eat the word of God, eat worship, eat praises, praise, read the word, prophesy, pray in tongues. Do that and you'll be surprised at how the Lord will visit you in a manner that no one has ever seen before. Amen. Number five. In the presence of the Lord, in the presence of the Lord, in the presence of the Lord, praise and worship the Lord. Amen. In the presence of the Lord, do what? Praise and worship the Lord. In the presence, praise and worship. Listen to this. When Paul and Silas were praising the Lord with chains on their hands and on their legs, the Bible says that the chains were broken and the gates were open and they were delivered. There can be no sick person who appears in the presence of the Lord and lives the same way he or she came. I'm here to announce to you, you will not stay in the presence of the Lord and your life remain the same again. As you land in the presence, there shall be a difference in your life. I want you to imagine this, that we are living on the last days, that anytime from now, Jesus Christ is coming back again. We can no longer concentrate on petty things. Even praying, the prayers we pray today, can you imagine that the only prayer you pray every day and the only preacher we preach every day is about God blessing you with money, God blessing you with a car. When we have non-believers with good cars. Now, if you are preaching or praying only about people with cars, what will you preach to Bill Gates when he comes? Nothing. You can't preach. You know why? This time, work hard to make sure that because the presence of God is already abiding in you, be determined to save a single soul in a day. You have fulfilled the great debt given to you by Jehovah God. Amen. One of the fine Sundays, we are going to decide, we just come, we pray together, then we divide ourselves into groups. And we go out there to preach to people. And you make sure at least minimum three people are saved before you come back. Is that okay? Wonderful. Another time, we shall go to Kenyatta Hospital. I'll divide in groups again. And I make you make sure at least minimum 3 people have been healed. Is that okay with you? Huh? Another time, tutaenda city mortuary. I know some of you fear dead people. But that's where we are going now. Where the presence of God is, the dead will walk. The blind will see. The lame will walk. The deaf will hear. Nothing will stand where the presence of God is. When you read the Bible, the work of the pastor or the fivefold ministry is to edify the church for the work of the ministry. So my work is to prepare you to go out and preach. How many people are going to help me on doing that? How many people are going to help me on doing that? Look at the person next to you and tell them, Jesus loves you. Now, that's how it begins. Amen. Ask that person next to you, do you know about Jesus? Uh-huh. Ask them again, have you given your life to Jesus? Let them answer you. In the presence of the Lord, we have all the solution that we need. So today, I don't want to see anyone praying, Father, bless me with a car. A car is nothing. Father, bless me with a husband. You are praying for your husband from January till December. He's not coming now. You can still go to heaven without a husband. You cannot go to heaven without Jesus. Father, bless me with a boy. Sorry, that's already done thing. What are we doing today? Today we are just praising the Lord. Amen. Amen. Praising who? Na yule mwenye unaona asifu Mungu, kuna mahali huwa anasifu. Na si hapa. I want us to pray. Can you stand up on our feet, please? Amen. 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 Lift up your hands. I want us to pray. I want us to pray. Just lift up your hands, everybody. Just worship the Lord in the house before we pray together. Just worship the Lord in the house. Just worship the Lord. Just worship the Lord. Just worship the Lord. Father, we love you. Father, we bless you. Father, we praise you. Father, we honor you. We give you praise. We give you praise. We give you praise. It's during this time that the presence of the Lord is in the house, that the Lord will minister to you in the name of the Lord Jesus. Just lift up your hands and praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. We worship you, Lord. Nina shanga nikielewa wewe ni zaidi ya vile nilivyoambiwa juu yako tena sauti yako yanisikia sauti zote ninazosikia ninashangaa ninashangaa nikielewa wewe ni zaidi ya vile nilivyoambiwa juu yako na sauti yako yanisikia sauti zote ninazosikia ninashangaa ninashangaa nikielewa wewe ni zaidi ya vile nilivyoambiwa juu yako sauti yako yanisikia Yale, the house. Everybody just worship him. Then the Lord, I love you. I worship you. I want to pray for you. Before we can pray, I want to ask a question. I want to have a question with you today. I want to ask, if you are there and you have never received Jesus as your Lord and Savior, and you are saying, Pastor, pray for me today, I want to start praying. I want to start by praying with you this very day. You want to give your life to Jesus. Lift up your hand, please, wherever you are. You want to give your life to Jesus. You just want to give your life to Jesus. You want to give your life to Jesus. Every eye closed, every head bowed down. Every eye closed, every head bowed down. You are saying, I want to give Jesus my life. I want to receive him as my Lord and my Savior. Kindly lift up your hand. I want to pray with you. I want to pray with you if you are there. God bless you, my sister. God bless you. Any other person? Any other person? Any other person? God bless you, my sister. Any other person you want to receive Jesus as your Lord and Savior? This is a day you will never forget in your life. You are receiving a new birthday today. Any other person who wants to receive Jesus as his Lord and Savior? You want to receive Jesus? You want to receive Jesus? Now, because of time, I want us to help our sister receive Christ as her Lord and Savior. So, my sister, just come, just come, just come. Pastor Charles, kindly, can you help lead her into repentance prayer? Can we give Jesus praise? When never one soul receives Jesus.
Talk anywhere.